स्टार्टिंग लेना है
स्टार्टिंग है
नमस्कार सर।
नमस्कार।
नमस्ते नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर आवर फेमस सीरीज ऑफ रीजनल कुजीन ऑफ इंडिया। सर, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू मेक बर्ली वांगी।
सर,
बर्ली वांगी इज ब्रिंजॉल, ब्रिंजॉल विच इज स्टफ अलॉन्ग विद द मसाला स्पाइसेस, the very unique blend of the masalas which you know, which is going to be dry roast, and then we'll make a blend of it and you know, make a powder of it. So the blend, what we're going to use it for, that masalas, what
masalas for the powder.
Yeah, this for the powder.
Yes. The come closer please. For the masala,
we are going to use coriander seeds, some methi, nutmeg,
fenugreek seeds, nutmeg.
Yes. Nutmeg, cloves, cardamom.
Stuffed, right? If I am not
wrong,
barley is stuffed.
Barley is stuffed. Stuff. The stuffing is unique, sir. I will show you how to make it.
Oh, right.
So how you gonna cut this one? We just gonna tip out the stem of the brinjal.
Okay.
And then little of the there's a crown which is there on the brinjal head. So I'm just trimming it out of some of the crown. And then with the stem you need to, so each corner of the brinjal will get marinated along with the masalas, and because of that marination this brinjal become very tender when you cook it. So it will take less time to cook your brinjals. So there's one, and I'll show you one more. Okay. We have already kept it some amount of brinjals which we have kept ready. Okay. Now we'll make a stuffing for this. So for that stuffing, I'll use this one. Okay. I'll wear gloves for some.
Single and.
So First we'll take onion.
Please come closer. Let have a look. How so, with and stuff.
Add some onion into it.
Okay. So chopped onion.
Chopped onion, which is raw. We don't saute it all, you know. So then we'll use some ginger garlic paste.
Into the raw onion.
Yeah, into the raw onion. Then we'll have turmeric into it.
Just add little turmeric into it. Then
the red chili powder will go into it.
I'm very curious.
Yeah. So we're gonna use little less red chili powder than yesterday one because it is not much spicier. Like yesterday Kolhapuri mutton was a little spicier side. Okay. But here this is the dish which is goes regularly and very, you know, every home to home it is very regular meal.
You can talk to the people straight under the camera.
And here we're gonna use next some good grated coconut
grated
into
coconut
it.
Next.
Yes. Then we'll have some Gouda masala into it. This is little different than the Kolhapuri masala, which doesn't have this very strong flavor
strong
and the pungent
flavorful spices like stone flour, maize is not there.
It is not there. That the spicy.
I can see here in the spices. Yesterday we have maize, nutmeg, stone flour into the spices, but here.
So for this now, chef, for to get some nutty flavor in your gravy, I'm gonna add some sesame seeds as well as your peanut into it.
Roasted peanut.
Roasted
skin
peanut.
Often crushed.
Crushed.
Okay.
And
nice sandy flavor dish.
And this is gonna be the chopped coriander will go into it. I'll add some jaggery, which gives you a little iron also into your dish.
Iron, iron and sweetness.
Yes, sweetness also into your dish. So now I'm going to mix this all together. You know,
The binding will happen when the onion release the water, the binding will happen like that.
Yes.
That will give some stuff into your brinjal, right?
Yes,
that
sir.
Will give a volume to the brinjal.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Good one. Shall we go near to the brinjal shop?
Yes, sure, sir.
You're done, right?
Yes.
I think you have not added salt in it. Salt is...
We'll add salt.
Okay. I'll get the salt finish. Is it enough, chef?
Yes, sir. Little more. Thank you.
Can I switch on the flame for the...
Sure, sir.
...for cooking?
Yes, sir. We'll wait for some time because we need to stop this all.
Okay.
And then we'll start with the cooking.
Good. So I can see nice. By seeing of this, I'm remembering all. Bundiyo, these kind of preparation will be made like this, right? Sure.
Yes.
Bundiyo,
now here, this when you crush all these things together, when you mix it all these things together, you will try to incorporate each flavor along with. Things and so because of that, without cooking of these masalas, you can start getting that fragrance.
Yes, I can feel that. I can feel the fragrance.
Yes.
I can feel the aroma.
So now we're gonna stop this.
Where else in South Indian we'll slip from the back? Okay.
Yeah. I have slid from the back also and from the front.
Where in South Indian South Ranger or Hutiwankai Pura, we slid at the back side. To four slits, we'll give in a four slits.
Yes, sir.
Which will open the brinjal's mouth very widely where stuffing goes full into it.
Yes. The wangi is nothing but your brinjals and your even Hindi we call as in the Bengal.
Bengal.
Yes, sir. Kannada they call as in Bandakai. Actually, there are different varieties of brinjal can be used for your, preparation, different preparations. So this is actually the variety of brinjal is called as a Pusa Purple Round. Is an agricultural name given by the agricultural society. So this is very, very, you know, familiar dish into the Maharashtra, in Maharashtra. Any kind of, you know, function at home,
okay,
you will find this dish. You know, if you don't keep this dish for the function and if there is a guest at home, they will be wonder how come this barley wangi is not there in your recipe, in your menu today.
Yeah, same as well as in South Indian also, sir.
Yes, sir. The gunti vakka ekora.
Any function is happening in South India, like especially in West Godavari, East Godavari, Prakasham district, or Guntur district. If you go there at that places, if they are doing any gatherings, social gatherings,
sure,
if they don't put brinjal into their dish, they feel very bad. People who comes to party, they feel very bad if they saw the brinjal. Brinjal is a prestigious
dish.
Issue.
Yes.
There is a song in Telugu film also too. Wow, what is that? Ravishar, can you please help out? Vankaya Raja, something is there in the Telugu film. Koragalalo Raja is Vankaya. Okay, there is one story also too. King of festival also is called. There's a king of fruits,
yes,
is mango.
Yes,
the king is called as king of festivals also too.
Yes.
Am I? If
and
not
it
wrong,
is very
yes,
easily
yes.
available for 12 months.
Exactly. If I am not wrong, Ravi, yes.
You are 100% correct.
So, yes, sir. Shop is talking about varieties of brinjals, right?
Yes.
Pink color.
Pink color, even you get purple
white color,
green color.
Yeah.
So, even this longer word.
The color will come with the pigment which is available in the.
Yes, sir.
Brinjal. Nice knowledge.
Chef, I'll tell you one,
yes,
in Maharashtra,
okay,
in this Diwali or after Diwali, when the harvesting is happening and all the things, no? So that is the actual season for your Bharteka Bengan,
okay,
right, the bigger one. Okay, so there, they generally have these parties in their farms.
Okay.
They generally have parties in their farms.
Maharashtra soil,
black in color, yes.
Okay, black in the color and they are good for the growing of
vegetables,
like onion,
yes,
radiation, all right.
Yes.
And the biggest producer in India is biggest onion producer is Maharashtra.
So
second,
second
largest state which they produce onion for the India.
Yes. So the
I'll help you. Just give it to me.
As chef told this, Maharashtra is the largest
producer of
the onion. So that way, India is the second largest producer of the brinjal. So the first one is, fortunately, this China.
Any questions being asked by the viewers? Is there any questions shoot by the viewers? Right.
So first, what we'll do, chef?
Yes.
We'll add oil into it.
Okay.
We'll add some ginger garlic paste.
Okay.
And then we'll saute some brinjals into it.
Okay.
Okay. And then as it starts getting a little darker color in the, we'll add our masala into it and we'll start cooking it.
Now I'm putting.
Yes.
Shall I add the oil, chef?
Bilkul, chef. Little. That's fine, chef.
Yes, chef. What's next? What shall I get in?
No, we'll add ginger garlic paste first and then this will go into it. Yes, one spoon.
Fine.
That's fine, sir.
Thank you.
Increase the little flame.
The raw flavor of the ginger garlic should be.
Yeah.
Then you're going to add this
brinjal,
which
yes.
has something to it.
Yes. So actually this masala will start, will help us to, you know, tender the brinjals.
Yes.
And it will cook a little faster.
Oh, the seasoning will start softening,
softening the vegetable
from the inside.
Yes, sir.
Then the brinjal will get cooked thoroughly in the center also.
Yes, sir.
Now this is the time we will start adding our brinjal into it.
This is the time to add the brinjal into the hot oil.
And just try to rotate it with and have a connectivity with the oil, so it can be get enough heat very well to the each part of the brinjal. So yesterday what we made is mutton kolhapuri.
Okay.
Actually, authentically, obviously, it goes with the two different varieties of the gravies along with it.
Okay.
So the mutton by itself is a costly. So the kolhapuri people, what they do the preparation with the three varieties. The first variety is your panda rasa. The second one is your tamra rasa.
What is tamra? What is pandra?
Tamra means red in color.
Okay.
Pandra means white in color.
Okay.
The pandra
it can
is,
be paired with chicken and can be paired with the mutton.
Yes, but authentically it has to be with the mutton.
Both of them suit well with the mutton, not with the chicken.
Not with the chicken.
Okay.
Now there is a variation comes like then the mutton is a little costly, so they started cooking it with the chicken.
Okay.
You can see it just started turning a little dark in color. Yeah. In thali chef, the Maharashtrian thali is very very famous.
Okay.
So for that particular thing, we have generally most of the Maharashtrians are like vegetarian side.
Okay.
So those what they do generally, they have two types of vegetables into it. Some mandal is there, then either a curd or a chaag, or a sol kadhi. As per the region, when you go to the coastal part of the Maharashtra, you get sol kadhi there. Rather than having curd, you got a sol kadhi there.
Okay.
But yes, vegetable, within 2 to 3 days, you will get brinjal curry in that particular thali.
Okay.
Yes. The restaurant do serve all authentic thalis and all the things. Within 1 or 2, after 2 to 3 days in the week, at least 2 times in the week, you get brinjal curry in it. Whether it is a Bengal ka bharta, your might be your barley wangi or might be your sliced brinjals cooked along with the onion and some sliced, some spices. Now we can see there is a, there's a
color
change in the yeah. So we're going to add
the brinjal mouth was opened widely.
Yes.
Now we are going to add this masala.
Yes, so we're going to add this masala into it.
And I'll boil one for you, please.
We'll just pour some little water into this and we'll stir it and we'll
cook.
I will reduce the flame of this. So now the brinjal and the rest of the masala will cook together and then
you need to add some more water into it, sir?
No, sir. If required, we need to do that one afterwards.
Okay.
We'll just cover this up. You can add, sir.
Nice color, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now we will cover this brinjals and we'll start cooking it further. Any questions, guys? From the viewers?
Sir, mutti cheese, sir. I've seen, I can see that which are the familiar dishes actually. Can't we explain about Malwa?
Sir, I'll explain with this Khandeshi chicken curry with the mutton.
Let them know what we have little Khandeshi chicken curry.
Yes.
Let them know what it is and how it is made.
I will explain those.
Please focus on Joshi Chef. Let him explain
this Khandeshi chicken. The way we made it, your goda masala here, with they use Meccan kala masala, black masala. So there they don't add your green cardamom and all the things. So they add just a blackish color masala, that is your black pepper, cloves, black elaichi, cinnamon, star anise, mace, bay leaf, you know, shahi jeera, all these things goes into it and then they blend it. Okay, here that's goda masala we have in the dry coconut also in it, then poppy seeds are there, cumin seeds are there, dry red chilies also in it. Okay, in the Kolhapuri masala, we added the lawangi mirchi, which has been dried and made it red. Okay, that red dried lawangi mirchi, we have used it for that particular thing. The ingredients matters here. So if you taste this Khandeshi chicken curry, you will have the spiciness from the masalas, not from the red chilies. Okay, though it is little reddish in color, it's because the masala goes sautés along with the oil. So that color comes into the oil with that particular masala. And then you get that flavor into the chicken. So this chicken is not regular broiler chicken, it's the desi chicken. So country chicken. This strong flavor masalas try to tender the meat. No, rather than adding any of the saring agent or the marination and then you keep it like that, no. There, here they just mix them with the masalas and they cook along with it. So here they don't do marination and all. Cooking all together is the final process of the Khandeshi chicken curry.
See, I can see masalas, if I see in South Indian, if we cook non-veg, we use more of masalas to cook non-vegetarian dishes.
Sure.
When coming to vegetable dishes in South India, we don't use more of spices with it.
No.
Like cloves, cardamom and cinnamon.
Sure.
But here I can see yesterday's dish which we got the meat.
Yes.
They got the spices also too.
Yes.
Like cloves, cardamom and cinnamon.
Yes.
Whereas coming to the vegetarian also, they got spices with it.
Yes.
Actually, we do some variations in South India.
Yes.
I want to know the why all these
spices.
This
is the only preparation which got a lot of spices into it. Okay, but if you see the aloki sabji, the sweet potatoes, if you get a pumpkin, you get a loki, you get the cauliflower and all these things, yes, goda masala will go into it by default. Whatever the region you have been sitting in the Maharashtra, whether it is a Khandesh, whether it is going to be your Marathwada, Vidar,
Malwani,
or anywhere you are be sitting there, but you need to use this. Your goda masala into it. But comes to your leafy vegetable just hardly garlic, cumin, some nuts like peanuts, chana dal, that's it, and green chili and salt. There is an actual way of preparing leafy vegetable. The more nutrients come from the leafy vegetable, right? So for to get that nutrition, they cook it along with that water by itself and the tempering goes from the top.
Good. It's more about nutrition.
Yes. Now you can see this. Now the masala is getting cooked.
Putin,
yeah, and even the brinjal is also getting
softened.
Yeah, it's getting softened. We need to cook little more, chef. So the masala will also get cooked little more, as well as the brinjals will
soften.
Yes. Malwani fish curry is like here all the masala is getting sauteed first. Okay, the Malwani fish is getting marinated with the ginger garlic paste, salt, turmeric and kokum. Kokum which is being soaked, like the tamarind will soak it. Okay, and then make a paste of it. Okay, so you get the tamarind pulp, here the kokum gets the pulp off of it. And then the pulp has to be rubbed well with the fish. And then it is being like last week we have seen the in Bengali cuisine we have fried the fish before we add it into the gravy, right? Here in Malwani, that is also very well known fish lovers or the fish state or fish region where every meal will, yeah, at least once a meal you will have the fish preparation in their meal. So there what they will do it, right? They don't cook it separately first and then they add it to gravy. No, they will cook the gravy first and that gravy will, you know, the fish will go, the marinated fish will go to the gravy. Right? But the gravy will generally happen with all the time here. Rest of the Maharashtra you might see the gravy which has the dry coconut into it. But yes, when you talk about the coastal part of the Maharashtra, that spoken region will have your fresh coconut into it. So the fresh coconut, little tomatoes, or your onion, curry leaves, fresh peppercorns also they do add into it. While sauteing your masala, they add your fresh fresh peppercorns, which the green in color. Okay, then dry red chilies into it, bay leaf. Okay, and then they saute all these things together and make a paste of it. After making paste, they add into, you know, again tempering, and then cook along with the fish. After it gets cooked, they add fish into it and then again get once more boil and take the seasoning and then serve it. So that is actually fun. When you go that particular, you know, the particular village, you go there, you will get
my teaching research.
Sure.
That was made with sprouts.
Yes,
then how many days it takes to make in a sprouts? If I use a mung dal, in how many days it will
be? It takes 2 days, chef.
2 days to get a spoon.
Yes, because you require at least 6 hours to get soaked well.
Okay.
Right? And then, then you need to drain it, then again cover it with the muslin cloth. And it has to be nicely wet, wet muslin cloth, keep it for resting. Then start getting sprouts on it.
Okay.
So slowly by slowly, when you feed this, the season like this, you will get within 1 day also. But the winter, it will take a little time. The humidity required.
Because of humidity,
yes,
the sprouts will be grown faster.
Yes. So, I just wanted to tell you one thing about this.
Okay.
Here, like, this is the, see, the festivals also, they do prepare some kind of things out of it. So, we'll add a little water into this. I think it starts sticking down.
This is your chef, you said that you are going to talk about.
Yes, sir. If, you know, very, look, the barley wangi, even they do take it as a, for the brinjal preparation, not as a barley wangi, but brinjal preparation, they do carry in their traveling also. Okay, because this is a vegetable you can carry, keep it for at least 10 to 12 hours after preparation. Like you just get nicely sliced, okay, saute along with the onion and some spices, the way I mentioned you prior. That the same way preparation, you can also take it along with your traveling. Where if you are traveling nowadays, you we can get food any, like even the
traveling by train also we do get meal into it. But prior it was not like that. So we do make a preparation in such a way and then we carry it. Yes, sir. You can see now this brinjals are like,
you can see these brinjals are, you know, breaking it very easily.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna.
A good stir.
Yeah, we're gonna serve it now with the brinjals. Okay. We'll add a little of coriander.
As a garnish.
Yeah, we'll mix it with the some coriander.
The freshness will come.
Yeah, yes, sir. Fish. Now I'll switch off the range. Yes, I'll disturb the flame. I'll do that, sir. The gravy should be like, you know, when we cook it with the masala, this masala has to be crunchy.
Okay.
If we see it to the
wankaya, it should not turn to the soft one.
Yes. If we see it to the guti wankaya, it has on a very
fine
paste as well as a very
this should
fine
gravy.
No, it has to be crunchy like this. Yes, then coriander, we'll keep it as a garnish here. Any questions?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Namaskar.
Namaskar.